My name is Mark Echo. I created a clothing company about 20 years ago called Echo Unlimited, and have built many different disparate consumer product companies off of that. Someone's throwing punches at you, kind of figure it out. You take a couple of shots to the head, you stand back up, you try not to take them so much, try to figure out ways to evade them and to return, right? I think the spirit of realizing your side hustle and your passion and pursuing your passion is less academic than we paint it. You just have to be prepared to know that the learning's just never, ever gonna end. I remember a moment when I started to go from just t-shirts, where it was just my art, screen printing, where that production cycle was kind of very tactical, I knew it. But the minute I started to go to cut and sew or like outerwear, right? Now you're dealing with seams. I remember sending my first drawing over to the manufacturer for a first piece of outerwear. And I remember I based it on a prototype of a jacket that I had bought for, let's say, just for conversation's sake, $50. I get back the quote from the manufacturer based on my drawing, and the price is like $35, like the cost. I'm the wholesaler that's gonna sell it to the retailer, so 35 times four is effectively what it's gonna cost at retail. So, you know, what's that, $140, right? So I'm thinking to myself, I based it on a jacket that was 50. What's going on? Why is it so expensive? He said, well, the consumption. I said, it was a learning moment. Consumption? Consumption, isn't that what you do when you eat? What do you mean the consumption? Well, your sleeves, the way you design the sleeves, you don't want a seam here. I'd drawn effectively a jacket that had no seam here. It was in my naiveness of designing it, I just forgot to put the seam. So it turned out that the way that they were gonna have to cut the fabric in the paper pattern was gonna consume more of the yardage. And so it made production more wasteful. Designing something without fully comprehending the limitations on the production side of the house, suddenly that became the rabbit hole to learn production. If you've got a dream, go realize it, right? And be prepared to have it hurt. And be prepared for the dirty secret, which is, it's gonna be lots of little failures that make success. How can you realize your voice, your passion, and what can you glean from these lessons? And I tell you, the gateway, the pearl to true education is a tolerance and acceptance and the embrace of failing and knowing it's gonna be painful. What's there for you? What are you gonna make of it? What's your brand? Look in the mirror, why don't you ask yourself? So you're not unique in having those questions. You have to discover that path. It is a self-motivated, self-directed journey. And if you don't know, figure it out, even if it's just 10 yards in front of you, and work to get to those 10 yards, and then figure out the next 10 yards, and then the next.